And a good morning to you, 8 o'clock. And you're looking live at Lake Tahoe right now. In just a few hours, skiers and snowboarders from across the valley are going to be heading up to the Sierra to spend the holiday weekend on the slopes. Good morning to you. I'm Adrienne Bankert.
And I'm Georgia Fitzpatrick. It's been about a month since the last long weekend surrounding, of course, the Martin Luther King Jr. holiday. That weekend, there really wasn't a lot of snow in the mountains.
Now, plenty has fallen since then, and the resorts are expecting much better business this time around. KCRA3's Brian Hickey is making his way down the hill this morning in Squaw Valley, making all the snowboarders and skiers a little bit jealous.
I'm jealous, I can tell you
that.
Are
you jealous right now?
Absolutely, and I'm jealous because there is some nice fresh snow to enjoy up there. So for those of you who maybe haven't been up since you were mainly dealing with the man-made stuff, Brian is coming into frame right now to tell us it's good.
Wait, let me get into the morning sun for you.
Oh, yes, yeah. Please. Warm yourself.
All I can say is I know the feeling down in the valley. I'm a diehard skier, and it's hard to get out of the valley when it's been so warm. All we hear about is the dry conditions. And, yeah, it's not the epic year that we had last year, but let me step out of the way of what Mother Nature has done up here. The last two storm systems have covered the mountains. All of the resorts up in Tahoe are now completely open. You got to be a little careful if you're going off in the trees and the rocks, because obviously there's still a lot of stuff exposed out there. But you can see for yourself, winter has arrived, just not as great as last year. But I'll tell you what is different from last year. On those holiday weekends, typically the resorts raise their prices. This year, they are lowering them. I've never seen discounts on a holiday weekend. Let me tell you what Squaw's got going on. Excuse me. Squaw Valley, you can get two tickets. They're calling it the Tahoe Super 2. Two tickets for $98, unrestricted. Any day through this holiday weekend and the rest of the season, you can go any 2 days, and that basically is $49 a day. On top of that, they're throwing in two half days, good for any Friday. That is the best deal up here in Tahoe right now, but you got to buy them by today, and they're good for the rest of the year. Sugar Bowl, if you've got one of those restricted blackout passes for holidays, they'll still sell you a ticket for $39. Anyone with a season's pass can go to Sugar Bowl and get $15 off a pass, and you can even buy one for your friend at that price. Sierra Tahoe, go down to REI before you head up the mountain, buy a 3-pack. That gets you on the slopes for $54 a day. If you just want to buy a 1 day, it's $58.99 if you buy it at REI before you head up the hill. Heavenly, check this out. Celebrating the fact that it's a leap year, they're going to throw that extra day in for you. They are basically, if you stay for the weekend, they're going to throw in that third night of lodging and third day of skiing absolutely free. Starts at $295 a person, so for $100 a day, you're getting lodging and a lift ticket. Lift tickets right now are over $90 if you walk up to the ticket window and buy one, so that's a smoking deal. And at Boreal, throughout the year, if you sign up for their iRide card, ski 2 days or snowboard 2 days, get the third day free throughout the season. So those are just some of the deals that you can cash in on as they try to entice you to get back into the ski and snowboard spirit up here in the Sierra. And I can tell you, it's what you just got to get here. The cold gets into you, the sun gets into you, and the snow, the groomers have been working overnight. I did my best to show you how good the corduroy is this morning, and I plan to go out and do a little more research a little later. So,
research. You are a very, very thorough journalist, that is for sure. All right, and a happy one.
All right, smiling big.
Have a great weekend.
All right, you too. You can find the latest conditions at many of those Sierra resorts all in one place, and that place, of course, is KCRA.com. We have the very latest information from all of the ski areas, and you can check out what the base is like, what the lifts are, which lifts are open, and even take a look at the road conditions for the major highways going through the Sierra. You'll find it all again at kcra.com/ski reports. And you can also find a link at kcra.com/weather and also on our mobile app.